Heya! I'm Valen from Mischief of Mice. Welcome to another Bit by Bit on Witchery, a Minecraft mod by Emoniph. As usual, I'll post some helpful links in the description, so let's begin. What you got for me today, Peaky? I've got a Death Protection Poppet. What are we covering today? Well, Death Protection Poppets, how to make them and use them. Plus, player infusions. There's plenty to choose from and lots you can do with each, so that's just a general topic. Let's get on with it. Death Protection Poppets. What are these? Well, first, to create one, you have to create a poppet. What is a poppet? It's kind of like a little voodoo doll type thing. It's not really originally intended to hurt you in this mod as much as it is to help you. Now, it's just made with some wool, bone needle, Spanish moss, and some string, as you see here. And to make a Death Protection Poppet, you take that basic poppet and you add Drop of Luck, Diamond Vapor, some gold nuggets around it, and you've got a Death Protection Poppet. Now, it's not going to be bound to anything. If you notice here, this one here says not bound. This one here says it's bound to Valen Frostweaver. To bind it to yourself or to others, you can put it in a crafting bench with a tag lock kit, and it will then become a bound Death Protection Poppet. And this will protect you from most sources of death, at least once. If you're constantly burning in lava, it may save you, but then you still might burn again afterwards. So please be aware of that. But continuing on, let's get on to the next part, which is infusions on the player. This can be hazardous to your health. So therefore, you now have Death Protection Poppets to help protect against that. So you'll notice that I have in my possession Ghost of the Light. This is created with a Fire Protection Poppet, Redstone Soup, Potion of Invisibility, and Potion of Fire Resistance, both 8 minutes, a Torch, and a Tongue of Dog. That Fire Protection Poppet actually is created as... Oops, just passed it such, with some Ember Moss, Woolabat around a regular poppet. And essentially, you don't want to drink it. It will give you a poison effect. It's not good to drink, but it's going to be used to create the Infusion of Light. Now, that, let's see here, and there's the Ghost of Light, how to create it with Redstone Soup Potion, all in a kettle here, with altar power of 4,000 nearby. To use it, according to Witchcraft Circle Magic, you must stand in the circle, put it down with two ritual circles, small and medium, and an altar power of 2,000. Which is what I'm going to demonstrate here. I'm in there, and there we go. I have been infused. Now, you notice on the left side of my screen, there we go, maybe you can see it now, I now have a little meter. This is my, I guess infusion meter would be a good way of describing it, but this is the amount of power I have to cast things with. And to do that, you need a witch's hand, which you can get as a rare drop from coven witches or regular witches that will poison you in the world. So, now to demonstrate the different powers that you can have with this new infusion. Now remember, this is just the infusion of light. There are others, and we will be going over those as well. There is no passive effect on this one, but there may be on some other ones. So, to give you a first example, holding right click will make you turn invisible. There you go. That was me wearing regular clothes that will actually turn invisible with me. Now, if you're wearing armor, let's actually get some here. Helmet. Let's put on a regular chain helmet works. Now, when I do that, you'll see the chain helmet's still there. So, just a heads up that only the witch's gear or other special items that will disappear with invisibility will actually turn invisible. And you can see here, when I do it, there you go. The witch's hand actually turns invisible with it. So you can still run around and do the things that you want to do sneakily without potion effects, which is pretty cool. But remember, you got to hold down the right click. Something you should be aware of is that sometimes you may be a little glitchy. If you notice, I'm kind of have parts of my body reappearing, so it's not perfectly reliable, but it can help you out still. All right, next item, Shift right clicking on a block will create a wall. There we go. And it's just like the wall that we saw before on the ritual. It's passable by you, but not passable by monsters. And it will eventually, there it goes, disappear over time. So let's see if I can. So you see, you can create temporary walls with this option. All right, the next one is similar, whoops, to the last one, but it's actually able to make a bridge. Now, if you look here, when I create the regular wall, I can actually jump on top of it. Each layer is its own block, which has a solid top and bottom. See, I can't jump up, but now I can. So if you were to, oops, I'm in flight mode now. If you were to be walking out and you need a bridge somewhere, you just shift right click and there you go. You've got yourself a pretty decent bridge. It goes a good distance. This one here should enclose mobs and players. So you see there, it actually worked. She is now enclosed, Morgana is, in this temporary force field. It only lasts for a few seconds, but it can actually help you to catch something that's getting away. But you do have to shift right click again, so it can be a bit challenging. And now a bit more fun here. Left clicking one raises the creature into the air and encases them. So I could do this with a whole bunch of witches here. Actually, that one, the if you notice, it actually needs the space to create that prison for them to be in. And they will eventually fall down, as expected. So there you go. That's the Infusion of Light. Some very simple passive things. And it will, let's see if I can actually, over here, you'll notice that meter, it hasn't moved. Well, I am in creative mode, and I'm doing this so that I don't need to refresh that. So, what other infusions are there? There are much more interesting ones if you don't want the Infusion of Light, which is pretty much just a lot of force field blocks, ways to traverse and turn yourself invisible. We're going into the next one here. It's going to be the Infusion of the Overworld. It involves a Soul of the World mixture, which is brewed as such, Tombstone, Mandrake Root, Rowan Sapling, a golden apple that is enchanted, which means it uses blocks instead of ingots, Potion of Regeneration for 2 minutes, and some redstone soup. You get two, and you will just use it in the same way. Now, if you already are infused and then you put it on here, it will just change your infusion over to the new infusion. And something I did not do before is show you that the reason you made the Death Protection Poppets is because you need them to protect yourself from the effect that will happen. By infusing yourself, it will kill you. So, you heard that ding and the damage that happened, and now my Death Protection Poppet is gone. So, make sure that you've got yourself a few of those, and you should be alright. The Infusion of the Overworld is more about manipulating metals. So, to give an example, these mobs here, I named each of them Rob, so they are Rob zombies. You can left click to give them a huge pushback because they're wearing metal armor. Now, if they're not wearing metal armor, it will not have the same effect. So let's bring a regular zombie egg here. And I will right click. Oh, if he's not going to punch me in the process, nothing happens to him. But the guy to his left, oops, there we go. See, nothing happens to this guy, but the other one gets shoved back really far. It's a pretty good knockback effect, but it only works on metal armored wearing entities. A right click on an enemy should disarm them if it is a metal weapon. There we go. I just disarmed that golden sword, but this guy's carrying a diamond sword, and I'm clicking. Does not work. So keep that in mind. Once again, metal manipulation. Another option is to right click on the ground and it will raise up a column of dirt. Simple enough. Now remember, that just raised up the dirt that was below it. So if I were to right click the side of this block, it actually launches it in a direction towards an enemy. So let's get this a little closer here. And see if I can launch this at one of these guys. There you go. Yeah, it does some damage. He took a couple, 2.5 hearts there. And that's pretty much just how it works. You can launch these bricks in the direction of enemies. There is another way of doing damage to enemies, but you got to be careful because it will also hurt friendlies. And that is to hold right click, and then you let go. And it does a wave of earth away from you. You heard that ding, meaning that it was ready. So you see these metal swords in there. If I shift right click, well, so therefore I'm sneaking. It draws the metal weapons to me. Actually, I think the gold sword is just out of my range, so let me get a little closer here. There we go. So you can see it actually works. It's a little bit slow, but you can use it to disarm and then absorb any weapons around you that are made of metal. So it can be useful to lessen the attack from hostile mobs or players. Yes, all these effects will work on players as well. So you can knock around people wearing metal armor, you can steal their weapons, and so on. Before I forget, you should know that if you fall on dirt or grass while under this infusion, you have a passive effect of taking no damage. So let me get to the other game mode, and you see I actually harvested that block when I landed on it. Now if you hold shift and do that, there is a possibility of creating an explosion in the area, but also it will cancel out the damage saving effect if it does not work. So just keep that in mind. And finally, we have a way of getting iron ingots directly from the ore without smelting. Now, it's not just iron, it works on all metals, but it does not work on things like diamond ore. So you'd shift, right click, and hold it, and nothing happens there, but you did see that I got the iron ore ingots. I now have 4. So, there you go. That is the infusion of the overworld. The next infusion is going to be the infusion of Otherwhere. For the infusion of Otherwhere, you will need Spirit of Otherwhere, which is Redstone Soup, Potion of Swiftness for 8 minutes, 2 Eyes of Ender, Drop of Luck, Will of Bat, and an Altar Power, 4,000 in a kettle. That should get you a couple of Spirits of Otherwhere, unless you have Potion Enhancement Familiars. So just put it down and right-click while standing in there. Once again, make sure you have your Death Protection Poppets. And this actually refreshed, if you look on the right or left side over here, you'll see it refreshed my infusion energy. Once we go through all these infusions, I'll show you how to actually do a rite of charging that will refresh those, instead of just having to recast those and waste a Death Protection Poppet and all those items needed for that. So, to begin with this one. There are no passive powers with the infusion of Otherwhere, but this one is more about getting around. So for instance, right click, I just teleported. Right click to a player or a creature, just like that. So you can see it's quite handy to get around real quick. Now if you want to get much further away, let's see, I've got that witch's circle way out there. If I just right click, it's too far. So if I hold it down, it says it's ready. And I can teleport all the way over. So that's pretty good. Let's head all the way back now. And there we go. I think I was accidentally casting a ritual that was right there at the same time. But I teleported away in time. Let's make sure I teleport back to this spot here in the future. So if I hold shift or sneak, right click, it has now set a recall point. So to get back to that location, right-click while sneaking, and it will teleport me back here. And this does work across dimensions, but it will use a bit more of your infusion essence, if you will. So it will also work on friendlies, but it's a different combination. You got to use left-click, be very close to them, and hold shift. And they will teleport with you. So you can actually teleport friends around with you if needs be. Or mobs if you so desire. Alright, next, let's see if we can actually teleport the entities elsewhere. Now, that was just me clicking left click. If I click that and anything else, nothing happens, but you can actually teleport a few times there, but you may end up killing them. Now, obviously, I was immune to the damage in that case, but just left-clicking an entity, it will bring you and that entity up into the sky, and they may end up taking some extra damage there. So just be cautious about that one. It's just a simple left-click. And for those interested, there are no passive effects on this one like there was on the last one. On to the last infusion, the Infernal Infusion. The Infernal Infusion is made as such, with a small and a medium Infernal Runes circles, Ultra Power 4000, and an Infernal Animus, which is a potion that you make in your kettle as such. And just so you can see that recipe, Demon Heart, which I've shown you previously how to get that and make Redstone Soup, Potion of Harming, which it's the instant damage 2, Refined Evil, Blaze Rod, and a Voodoo Poppet. Now, a Voodoo Poppet can be used to control damage or otherwise influence others, but we're not getting into that. I'll just show you how to make that. That's Fermented Spider Eye, Mandrake Root, Exhale of the Horned One, Belladonna Flower, and all around a Poppet. So, take that, put that on here, and you then get the effect there, which I already had it going on, but you'll see on the left side of the screen, I currently have the new meter, which, as I said before, it was there. But in order to use the powers of this one, you'll need a witch's hand, same as before. But it's going to be a bit different. There are no passive effects until you actually start using it, which I will demonstrate here. Let's start by grabbing a mob spawn egg here. Spawn spider. So I'm going to spawn two spiders. And what you need to do is influence one. Shift left click, well, essentially you will not so much possess them, but make them friendly towards you. And you can have them attack others by just left clicking. Now it's daytime, so it's going to ignore some effects a bit, but there you go, see, they're fighting each other now at this point. Oh, and mine lost, but that's okay. I can just possess this guy, so now he's my friend. Now, you can actually sacrifice the creature that you have enthralled. You can actually enthrall multiples, but by sacrificing one, until you sacrifice another one, you will gain some inherent abilities. Some are passive, some are active. But basically, you just shift left click again, and if you look on the left hand side of the screen, you notice I have a little spider face and 10 little white bars there. That is the number of uses I have on using my special spider powers. Now, as far as the spider goes, I have the inherent ability to climb walls. Now, just by pressing forward, I automatically will walk up and over walls. Let's go over here to this big tree, and there we go. There's no vines, no stairs, nothing like that. I just automatically climb surfaces. Pretty cool. But it also has other abilities. In this case, it is to shoot a web. Oops, right click. There we go. So if you right click, it will shoot a web at a creature. So let me actually spawn another spider. And I can web him. So by hitting him, it will just web the creature. Of course, spiders are immune to it, so let me grab another egg here. Bat's a bad choice. Let's go with a zombie. Alright. He's probably going to burn, so I will put him in this spot over here. But there you go. You see, it just kind of instantly webs the creature that you're doing. And as it goes, it will use up your uses of the web attack on the left side until you sacrifice another creature. So, for instance, I can do this. Let me change my game mode, and I will web a bunch of times. You see the meter going down, and then I'm going to sacrifice him, and the meter's full again. So, I mean, find another spider, get more powers. Now there are other creatures, many other creatures, some of which will are they are the same on one creature as they are on others. For instance, the powers you gain from a bat are the same as you get from an owl. So you could sacrifice a bat or an owl and gain their powers. Same thing with slimes and was it toads, I believe. So therefore, there is some overlap, but not too much. As you can see, there's a lot of spawn eggs. I'm going to be going through each one of these and show you the different powers. Here we go with the bat. He is now enthralled. You can see little particles. I got lucky with clicking there. You know how they tend to just try and run away. Now, if I can get him to come here. Duh, that's not what I wanted to do. Hold on. Come here. By shift right clicking, it tells him to come to a spot. Now, it being a bat, his AI is not that good. I'm gonna end up webbing my entire world here. Come back. Ah! Hold on. Okay. Well, that didn't go so well. Let me try with another bat. Okay, forget a bat. Let's just use an owl because obviously that's not going to work. All right, so he is now enthralled, and there we go. I sacrificed him so that I gain his powers. Now, if it was a bat, I'd have a little bat face on the left side, but it's not. It is an owl face, and I will go back into my regular game mode here. Okay, so with this, you gain the ability to fly to a point. It's a double jump, just like you would in creative, but once you're in the air, I mean, it's kind of like a jetpack more than anything else. But it's kind of difficult to control. If you hold shift at the right time, it will lessen the impact of the fall. So that's kind of cool there. And then, of course, the other ability is, let's see here. There we go. Night vision. So you have a passive effect of being able to fly like you have a jetpack. And the night vision is the active ability that you can use 10 times per sacrifice. All right. Next one. All right. Spawn creeper. Now, this is a bit trickier, especially if I spawn one and he's really close to me. So I'm going to, for the sake of demonstration purposes, get into game mode one. And there we go. Now he's enthralled, and if I go back into my regular game mode, he's not going to explode. He's passive to me. So, come over here. So you can kind of direct them around, shift right click just to get them to move a bit. A lot better than that bat that I had earlier. All right, so let's sacrifice him, gain his powers. All right, one of his powers are to blow up. Obviously, he's a creeper. So he does have that going for him. You get to use that 10 times just like anything else. And it being a creeper, I don't feel so bad about sacrificing him. Now there is another ability of his that is actually pretty darn cool. It's a passive effect, but extremely difficult to do unless you know some witchery. And that is, if you're struck by lightning while you have the abilities of the creeper, it will recharge your infusion. So that's one way of doing it. Basically, you become a charged creeper. So that's pretty cool. Next one. Alright, the next one is a squid. So just to make sure that we've got some, there we are. I see I've got bubbles going on here. And he's enthralled. And I don't know if it's going to work that I tell him to go over here. If it works. Yeah, it's kind of a... He's doing it. It's just a very difficult place. I just accidentally drowned, but that's right. I had a poppet. All right, so let's sacrifice him. There we go. Now I have squid powers, which, if you notice, my bubbles are not going down. So I have underwater breathing. I have a little faster swim speed. And I can blind a target player or entity. So you can see the particle effects on him. He is now blinded. Obviously, it's just for a short time. And I have my water breathing going on. So, all right, next one. Next is a zombie. There he is. And let's just, there we go. Obviously, his AI is a little bit better for commanding and telling him to attack creatures and whatnot. But we're just going to straight away sacrifice him. And you'll notice no effects. What does a zombie give you? Well, he gives you bonuses by using his ability. He doesn't really have a passive. So there we go. Resistance 2 and strength. Not too shabby. 10 uses of that, so you can do some damage. Yeah. Next one. Next is a zombie pigman. All right. Once again, he's enthralled, and I sacrifice him. Now, you can't really sacrifice any that aren't enthralled, so just a heads up. Now, his ability is that I am immune to fire damage. And that's a passive effect, so that's pretty strong, actually. The other thing is, when I use his, it's a strength 3, resistance 3, and of course, I have fire resistance going. So it's a really big buff. Pigmen, in my opinion, are really worthwhile for that, especially if you're combat heavy or just need to mine in the nether, then, you know, you can get your resistance bonus going on there. All right, on to the next one. All right, this next one's a bit tricky. This is a ghast, so let's see if I can catch him before he flies away or kills me. Alright, he's enthralled. Let's see if I can fly. There we go. So he has now been sacrificed, and you see I have his abilities over there. Now, just to give you an idea, let's switch back to the alternate game mode here, and I am, once again... I thought I was resistant to fire. Oh, there we go. Yes, I am resistant to fire. It activated the effect upon me taking the damage. So you will take some at the beginning, but it will go away after that. Now, the other option, the other item that you get from this is the ability to shoot fireballs. Pretty darn cool. Let's actually go over here and lay waste to this town. Oh, that's stone, so it didn't work that well, but let's try just like ghast fireballs here. It does a little damage to weaker items, obviously the stone having a bit more resistance to it. But hey, there you go. And of course, your immunity to fire damage that you can cause. Next creature. Alright, this next one is a blaze, and like the ghast, maybe a little difficult to catch, so I'm just going to spawn him and stay in creative until I get a hold of him. There we go. Come here, you. And we're going to sacrifice you. Actually, let's make an omelet. We're going to enthrall you, and we're going to tell you you need to come over here. Yeah, that's a bit far. So let's tell you... Oh, give me that. I forgot, you can't right-click those guys. Let's make another one. And we'll tell you... to attack this guy. No, that's not going to work. Because he's immune to fire damage. There we go. And now they're just basically going to set fire to the entire landscape because they're both immune to fire. As am I, being in this room. But as you noticed, I also have the ability to shoot fireballs. Now being creative, it's a bit OP, but you shoot three little fireballs. So there's one launch. Well, actually, you see there's three fireballs launching out at once. Not quite like the blaze where he shoots one, two, three fireballs, you shoot all three. Alright, so I think I might just chill these guys out here. There we go. And on to the next one. Alright, this next one is for slimes, magma cubes, toads, and so on. And... tricky to catch. There we go. And my game mode is back to normal. Let's sacrifice him. And you'll see I gain the ability. What do I get? I automatically get this really weird slow motion jump as a passive. And I bounce like a slime does. Alright, this is me just holding jump once. I'm holding it down. So, and I let go. It's just kind of weird. Now, if I actually activate his ability, I get a super jump and immunity to the fall damage from it, which is totally crazy. Boy, now I'm not wearing any kind of gear right now. So you can see that. That's pretty cool. Lots of fun to be had. And if I add in extra stuff that gives me a jump boost as well, and then use it, you can get some really crazy high jumps out of this. Alright, on to the next one. Alright, this one is spawn silverfish. This egg is going to spawn a silverfish. Let's see if I can catch him. There we go. I'm going to sacrifice you right away because he just has a single track mind to try and kill me. Anyway, I have his ability, and already, let me take this off here. Oops. All the things I do, I land in water. Alright. I already am not running. I'm doing pretty good speed here compared to normal speed. And if I use this ability, you can see I get super speed. Oh, I almost landed in the water again. Look at that. So I get a speed 4 effect. It's pretty darn good. Of course, even going through spiderwebs, not too bad. All right, and on to the next one. All right, this one is cats, dogs, horses. I think it might actually be very similar to the silverfish as well, but... And a lot of people won't like seeing this, but hey, it's just pixels, people. Alright, so, got a horse, and I have a faster movement speed already. This is me just walking normal, without my super speed sash on. And if I were to use its ability, once again, I get super speed. Oops, not super jump, just super speed. Speed 4. Same as the silverfish. On to the next one. And this one is skeleton. So I'm going to spawn him and try and enthrall him quickly. There we go. And sacrifice. Alright, so that skeleton has a couple different abilities. He has like a lesser water breathing ability. So once my bubbles get down, you'll see what's going on. While I'm waiting, I'm just going to get rid of that. And you see I am equipped with water breathing now for a bit. So I have a lesser water breathing effect going on from skeleton. Oops, let's make it daytime again. The other thing is you can shoot magic arrows. Of course, it's just like shooting a bow. So you have to kind of hold it down and then release. Otherwise, it'll be... you'll shoot yourself. Or just very poorly like that. And you can collect the arrows, as I just did. So therefore, you get basically 10 free arrows that doesn't require a bow. On to the next one. Alright, this one here is to spawn an Enderman. So just so he doesn't teleport away, I'm going to go into game mode 1. And then we're going to enthrall him and sacrifice him. Which is funny because he actually just teleported away, but if you look on the left, you can see that it actually worked. Anyway, the ability he has, you guessed it, to teleport. Well, that's a little too far. There we go. So you can teleport short distances. Just like an Enderman would. Now, I'm in creative, of course, so you only get 10 uses of it per Enderman. And the last one. Alright, so this last one, cows, chickens, pigs, it might even work for villagers depending upon how it goes for you, but cow, and sacrifice him. So every time that you end up sacrificing one, you gain an extra bar on this. Kind of weird, a little different. The reason for that is if you notice my health bar. Once that message goes away, I'm at about 4.5 hearts. Now, if I right-click, I gain a full heal effect. So it's pretty powerful. So you kill a whole bunch, or sacrifice a whole bunch of animals, you can gain a complete refill of your health. Not too shabby. And that about does it for the Infernal Infusion. So next we'll be going on to the right of charging, so that as you can see, my meter there on the left is almost empty. Ways that you can refill that without having to sacrifice all the items that you did to get this infusion in the first place. So to recharge your infusion, here let me change back to game mode 0 here, you'll want to set up two white circles here. And make sure you've got an altar of 4,000. Now, it might actually be worthwhile just to have an altar set up just for this. Because if you see here, recharge infused power by standing in the circle lasts indefinitely, but it requires 40 power per second. So if you have an altar that can hold that up, then therefore you could have this running at all times. And all you have to do is walk up to it and just get yourself recharged. Altar power 4,000 and... potion of regeneration for 45 seconds. So I'm going to get this going. And you can see on the left side there, and you can hear the dings, it is recharging. Almost there. There we go. And you can see with the red particle effects, it's still running. So if I were to... let's say we're not going to do that. Enthrall one of these guys here. And then cast it a bunch. You'll see that my meter has gone down a little bit. Not much. And it refills again. Just like that. So having one running, you could just, you know, whenever you get low, get back to it, recharge, and you're good to go, and you haven't wasted anything except for the ingredients for a potion of regeneration. I think if you end up logging out or something, it might stop unless you've got a chunk loader, if it's on a server, something like that. But otherwise, it's worth experimentation on that. I'm not going to give it a go just because I think it's just fine. It's not very expensive as it is. But anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this. I'm Valen Frostweaver with Mischief of Mice again. I know that this has been a bit longer of an episode. I hope you found this helpful. Feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And until next time, see ya!